you may be struggling with making low poly characters, but no more. Today, I'm going to walk you through all the steps that you need to create your own characters. Starting now, let's hop in.
To add images, all you got to do is just go, you can say in the front view, it makes it easier, just go Shift A, image reference, and it pops up with your file browser. Just go find your image. Okay, and you select load reference images and it pops into your scene. I'll leave the link to this down below if you want to use it. Then I go to this right tab, change the opacity to like 0.25 or something low like that. And then just move around and then go G and Y and drag your image back. Now we need to line it up. So just go Z and wireframe and then G, X and line it up in the middle like this. Cool. Then go to top view, Shift and D and put it over here. Rotate Z 90, press negative so he's facing the right way, and then you can just align it up here. All right, cool. So now we have our references. Okay, select the cube in the middle of a scene or add one in if you deleted it. Then tab, go to edit mode, and then I'm going to go Control R, add a edge loop in the middle, select the left side, X vertices, and add a mirror modifier like that. Click on clipping so it doesn't get rid of it in the middle. Okay, now go to side view and start positioning everything. So you could do an easy way is just to go like on the right, just go right click, vertical split, and put in the middle. So now you can go on the left, you can go to front view, and then on the right, go to side view. And press T to get rid of the side panels. Okay, so now you can see we can have both of them. We can have both of them, we can have the front and the side view. So when we move something, you can see we can see both sides of it. So let's start positioning everything. So it's very simple. Let's just start with moving these to the top. So just pressing G and then bring this down to the bottom like that. And then on the front, let's go GX. Let's select both of them, GX. Select these, GX. Okay. And then you can just go add like, I don't know, two, maybe three edge loops. Then just position them like the references. And then position the like the references as well. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this edge. I'm just going to go G twice to slide it, and then select these and G twice to slide it. Just rounds out the body a bit. So we also need a like a square that we can extrude the arm from. So I'm just going to position these a bit better there. This has a good position to extrude them from. All right, now let's go work on. So I'm just going to go drag these up over here. And select this and extrude down just like the whole pelvis now. So there. And then we can just go here. Yeah. And then like drag here, bring these there, and maybe add an edge loop so you can make the glutes in the back. So a lot of the time it's just a bit of like trial and error moving around all the different things. So sometimes I like to just use this to kind of create like the ribcage kind of shape. And then that'll be for the pelvis, and then there, and yeah, I think that looks fine. So then select this face, and then we're going to go clipping and turn that off. So the reason is now we can extrude down, and now the legs won't be sticking together in the middle. So there, and we can just start working on the leg shape. So I'm just going to follow the right one there, and then here. You can position it over here, and if you have the loop tools add-on, you can press W, loop tools, and circle, or I think you just press right click if you're using left click select. You just want to pull up this vertex context menu and then just do there to circle it, or just move them to kind of get it into like a square shape like that. Okay, and then I'm going to go add some edge loops, maybe two, maybe three, depends. There, just press G, drag that in, G, drag this in, and then we actually want an edge loop to be directly on the knee, like this, then scale it down, bring that there, and then drag this in, and then drag that out a bit. Okay, select this face, extrude it down, it's going to be for like the calf, and extrude again, and then there, you can see it looks very weird front view, so let's go like rotate these, scale them down, like on the X axis, same thing here, S and X axis, and then yeah, this is looking fine. I kind of want to add a edge loop on the side like this, and then just press Alt and S to kind of round it out a bit, and then you can just select these edges and then just G twice to edge slide them, and then you can just turn on clipping again and then bring these back to the middle so it isn't clipping, it isn't like pulling away. and then bring that down a bit. And yeah, I think that looks quite nice. Okay, so let's work on the arms now. So I'm going to select these two faces up here, round it out a bit, and then maybe drag this down there. Okay, and then we're just going to go extrude it out. And then T poses are usually not A poses, or just straight down arms is usually not the best. So I'm just going to select my reference, Shift D to duplicate, and then hide the one behind it, or just hide this one. And then I'm just going to like rotate the arm just so we can get the same proportions and get it like here, just so that we can model the arm and don't have it get messed up, because we don't have the it straight down, which can really mess it up. Okay, so here, let's add an edge loop in the middle. You can right click, loop tool, circle, there. So let's just fix these as well. Loop tool, circle. So here, let's just make this like further down, I think. Maybe select the arm and drag it like here. Okay, this reference having like that is kind of throwing me off. I'm just going to make this a full screen one again, so you can right click and join or just drag it, and then let's just scale these up, or maybe just bring back that reference. Let's see, so we obviously need to make these quite a bit bigger, so there, add the that thing for the forearm, maybe make the wrist slightly smaller, this will be for the bicep. Bring it forward like there, and then I like to bring this one up because it's going to be for the tricep, like that. And then you want this to go there, kind of look a bit more like a proper shoulder. And then sometimes I would like drag this down and bring this in, there's more like a thing goes down. And then it also like wraps around, which is just better for like animation in general. Okay, let's go back to my other reference. So unhide this one. The shoulder looks a bit weird still. Let's drag these. Maybe make it further down and then scale this here. Okay. And then I'm going to rotate the arm forward like this. Okay. And then what I'm going to do for the neck is I'm going to select this vertex over here, Control and B to bevel it, and press V to do vertex like that. And then I'm going to just go K for the knife tool, and then join these like this, and then K, join these like this, and then select this, and then loop tools, circle. So that doesn't look very round, so I'm just going to scale X, maybe round it out there. Okay, and then we can drag this up slightly. Sometimes you should change this. And then what can work quite well is, like, if you go K with an R tool again, and then just go there, and then drag this in, so it's kind of like the collarbone. And then if the shoulder's like further up. And then you could also just like go knife tool like this to add a just the chest in like that. Or even like have it go multiple, so like there. It's not great topology, but yeah, look nicer. Up to you. Okay, and then the neck, we can just go extrude up there. And then yeah, drag that forward. There. Okay. And then for the face, what I usually like to do is just go Shift A cube and Shift A mesh cube, and then just go subdivide it. So you can press Control 1 or add a subdivision on the modifiers, and then just go scale it and position it so it's like over here. Okay. And then apply like there, and then just drag this down. Okay. And here. I'm just going to mirror it. So another way of mirroring it is if you go to Edit Preferences and Add-ons and add a mirror modifier, and then you mirror add-on, so it's called Auto Mirror, and then you can just go like Edit, Auto Mirror, and Auto Mirror, and it just automatically does it for you, which can make life quite easy. But I usually use that when I'm modeling. So here, it starts shaping the kind of jawline that we want. Sometimes I like to bevel these, like this, just to give myself a little bit more topology to work with. Or even just use it like there. And then we need another one for like the bottom of the face. This is maybe a bit too far up. We make the forehead a bit bigger, like that. Okay. And then we can probably get rid of this, the triangle, like that. And then for this middle part, we can just go inset it. So let's go R and press B for boundary, and then X and faces. Okay. And then we can need to start joining this up. So these, just delete this top face and drag it down a bit. So select the top of the face and select the body, Control J to join them. And then we can just start filling it up with F. So maybe like there. Okay. And then fill, fill, fill. Okay, cool. That worked kind of well. So here, we drag that in, drag that out. Because usually the kind of like bump in the back of the head will be further up. Okay, so there, that looks okay. I think that's better. And you can make a bit more of a chin there. Okay, cool. Yeah, there. And also like a decent jawline. And yeah, there, it gets kind of done with the face. I think it's a bit short though. So maybe S and R. So, this legs are looking a bit big right now, and this one's crossing over for some reason. Turn it clipping slightly there, and you can just do like Alt S if you want to make it slightly smaller. Okay, and then let's make some feet. So select it, scales at zero, maybe scale it up and extrude down. Just S, Z, and zero if you want to make it flat, and then just like scale Y. Select this, extrude Y. And you can like select the front and just go G and Z, drag it down like that. Select the side of it and then G and X. You can see this looks weird, so just drag that out as well. So there. You can drag the scale the feet in a bit maybe. You could also go, what I usually like to do is select like this front part, Control B to bevel, and then kind of like round out the foot like this. And then maybe drag that out a bit, G, Z. Okay. And then sometimes adding a edge in the middle can be helpful. J. And usually would also lean like that. And there. Okay. And then maybe G, Z. And then join these. So it kind of just has like the arch in the heel. Okay. Maybe this heel's too small. You can also just like add another edge if you want over here. I think it's fun. Cool. So then we have the last thing, which is the hands. Okay. So for the hands, what we usually want to do, maybe make the wrist a bit like flatter, like there. And then make it a bit more squarish. And then bring that one like further up. And then just extrude out like this. So this can be like palm size. So there. Select these two faces, extrude it out. And then there. And then extrude it out again. And then probably bevel it. You have the three segments. Okay, and then we can just do there, kind of create a hand shape, and then add an edge up on the hand, and then just drag it out like this, and then this is going to be for the thumb. So rotate it, extrude down. You can probably use a loop tools circle. Okay.
If you enjoy this video, then you might want to learn how to make low poly clothing. So click over here to learn how to do that. Cheers.